Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. Guys, in today's session we will discuss about the operation screen from top to total. जो हमने थोड़ा time पहले पढ़ा था उसमें कुछ नई updates आई हैं. We will discuss that new update and also we are going to discuss about the recently held third assembly of International Solar Alliance. And other than this, we will discuss some more important questions from the PIB news. But before we begin, guys, do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the sessions. Okay, and let's start with the question number one, which is about the operation greens from top to total. So which of the following is incorrect regarding the operation greens from top to total? So guys, recently हमने कुछ टाइम पहले पढ़ा था ड्यूरिंग द आत्मनिर्भर पैकेज कि जो ऑपरेशन ग्रीन्स है जो कि पहले केवल टॉप के लिए था उसको एक्सटेंड कर दिया गया है फॉर टोटल. राइट, सो ऑपरेशन ग्रीन्स की बात कर लेते हैं पहले. लेट अस फर्स्ट डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑपरेशन ग्रीन्स. सो ऑपरेशन ग्रीन्स टॉप फॉर ऑपरेशन ग्रीन्स फॉर टॉप यानी कि टोमेटो अनियन पोटेटो इट वॉज अनाउंस्ड इन द बजट स्पीच ऑफ 2019. टोमेटो अनियन पोटेटो अदर देन दिस टू प्रमोट फार्मर प्रोड्यूसर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एग्री लॉजिस्टिक्स एंड प्रोसेसिंग फैसिलिटीज फॉर 3 crops ऑफ टोमेटो अनियन पोटेटो. लेकिन इसके बाद इसको एक्सटेंड कर दिया गया इन 2020 आत्मनिर्भर पैकेज के अंदर 2020 में इसको फ्रॉम टॉप टू टोटल कर दिया गया. और टोटल का मतलब यहाँ पे ईच एंड एवरी क्रॉप नहीं है, इट इज फॉर ऑल फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स. टोटल का मतलब यहाँ पे क्या है, ऑल फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल्स. ओके, एंड इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड गाइस फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 6 months. करंटली इट हैज बीन एक्सटेंडेड फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 6 months, बट अगर जरूरत पड़ी तो गवर्नमेंट विल एक्सटेंड इट फर्दर. राइट, and it has been extended to protect fruits and vegetable farmers from distress sale due to lockdown, because we all know due to lockdown jo unka fruits and vegetable ka sale tha wo nahi ho paya tha. So that is why unko distress sale se bachane ke liye this step has been taken by the government of India. And under the extended scheme do subsidies provide karai jayegi to the farmers at 50% of the cost. Total cost jo bhi hogi, जिस चीज के लिए भी वो सब्सिडी प्रोवाइड कराई जा रही है उसका टोटल कॉस्ट का 50% सब्सिडी विल बी प्रोवाइडेड. एंड व्हाट इज द किस लिए सब्सिडी प्रोवाइड कराई जाएगी? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फॉर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन ऑफ एलिजिबल क्रॉप्स फ्रॉम द सरप्लस एरिया टू द डेफिसिट एरिया. जहां पे जो क्रॉप्स है फ्रूट्स एंड वेजिटेबल की, जहां पे सरप्लस है और जहां पे डेफिसिट है, उन दोनों के बीच में ट्रांसपोर्टेशन का जो भी कॉस्ट लगेगा उसका 50% ऑफ द सब्सिडी will be provided by the Ministry of Food Processing and Industry. And other than this, jo storage facilities provide karai jayengi to the farmers and to the farmer producer organization and to the cooperatives also. Aur uska jo bhi kharcha aayega, total cost hoga, uska 50% subsidy will be provided by the government. Okay, and ye jo transportation hai guys, ye road aur air teenon ka hai. Okay, रेल रोड एयर तीनों की ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इसमें इंक्लूड है. कहीं से भी जाए तो 50% ऑफ द सब्सिडी विल बी प्रोवाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. एंड द न्यू अपडेट इज दैट नाउ द मिनिस्ट्री हैज डिसाइडेड टू गिव 50% सब्सिडी ऑन द फेयर्स ऑफ किसान रेल आल्सो. ऑलरेडी जो नॉर्मल ट्रेन है उनके ऊपर 50% सब्सिडी दिया जा रहा था बाय द गवर्नमेंट, बट नाउ इट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड ऑन द स्पेशल किसान रेल आल्सो. ओके, इसका मतलब ये हुआ जो भी किसान रेल का फेयर होगा उसका 50% विल बी बोर्न बाय द बेनिफिशियरी. 50% will be borne by the beneficiary, rest 50% will be given by the Ministry of Food Processing and Industry to the Indian Railways. Okay, जो बाकी 50% है वो कौन देगा? Ministry of Food Processing and Industry किसको? Indian Railways को. Okay, and किसान रेल गाइस, आई होप आप सबको पता है किसान रेल को स्टार्ट किया गया था ताकि जो सप्लाई चेन है उसको डिस्टर्ब ना हो फॉर सीमलेस सप्लाई चेन. ओके, seamless supply chain of goods and perishable commodities. Okay, so Kisan Rail was launched for this purpose and first Kisan Rail was inaugurated from Devlali to Danapur. Okay, Devlali to Danapur, and Devlali is in Nashik in Maharashtra and Danapur is in Patna in Bihar. And recently second Kisan Rail has also been inaugurated, and this second Kisan Rail is first from South India. And from where in South India? Anantapur in Andhra Pradesh to दिल्ली. दिल्ली में कहां पे? आदर्श नगर. ओके, आदर्श नगर रेलवे स्टेशन तक ये ट्रेन जाएगी. सो फर्स्ट किसान रेल फ्रॉम देवलाली टू दानापुर Denali is in Nashik, Maharashtra, and Danapur is in Patna, Bihar. And second, Kisan Rail, and first from South India is from Anantapur in Andhra Pradesh to Adarsh Nagar in New Delhi. Okay. So I hope guys this news is clear, and now let's come to the question. So we have to identify the incorrect statement regarding the operation greens from top to total. So this operation is for all fruits and vegetables. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And remember, it has been extended for 6 months only. It is currently implemented for 6 months. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And under the scheme, 50% subsidy on the fares of Kisan Rail is provided by the Ministry of Food Processing and Industry. So this is also correct, which means none is incorrect will be the correct answer, option D. Okay. And now let's guys talk about the third assembly of International Solar Alliance. इसमें से एक question या दो question आपके exam में 100% है, जो भी आपका upcoming exam है उसमें इस topic से question जरूर आएगा. So pay attention to this. So recently third assembly of International Solar Alliance was held virtually under the presidency of India and co-presidency of France. Okay, co-president under the presidency of India and co-presidency of France, it was held virtually. Okay, and during this event, India and France have been re-elected as the president and co-president for the next 2 years. अगले दो सालों के लिए India और France को re-elect कर दिया गया है for the president and co-president. Okay, and currently the president of India, यानी कि जो International Solar Alliance की presidency है वो India के पास है, और India की तरफ से जो उसके chief है वो कौन है, R.K. Singh, the Minister of New and Renewable Energy. Okay. And other than this, vice president, have also been announced for all the four regions. And remember the name of the four regions also. क्योंकि exam में ये direct question पूछा जा सकता है, which of the following is not one of the four regions of the International Solar Alliance. So you have to remember the name of the four regions also of the International Solar Alliance. मतलब basically International Solar Alliance ने पूरे दुनिया को चार regions में डिवाइड किया हुआ है, और वो ये हैं चार रीजन, और इन चारों रीजन के जो वाइस प्रेसिडेंट्स हैं दे हैव आल्सो बीन अनाउंस्ड. सो फॉर एशिया पैसिफिक रीजन इट इज फिजी एंड नाउरू, फॉर अफ्रीका रीजन इट इज मॉरिशस एंड नाइजर, फॉर यूरोप एंड अदर्स रीजन इट इज यूके एंड नीदरलैंड्स, एंड फॉर लैटिन अमेरिकन कैरिबियन रीजन इट इज क्यूबा एंड गयाना. ओके, सो रिमेंबर द नेम ऑफ वाइस प्रेसिडेंट्स आल्सो, एंड दीज आर सम अदर की पॉइंट्स. So the assembly approved institutionalizing the ISA's engagement with public and private sector through Coalition for Sustainable Climate Action. This Coalition for Sustainable Climate Action, ये क्या है basically? It is a project of International Solar Alliance for partnership for partnering with private and public sector to combat the climate change. जो भी climate change है उससे लड़ने के लिए, क्लाइमेट चेंज से लड़ने के लिए इसमें आईएसए जो है वो पब्लिक और प्राइवेट सेक्टर के साथ पार्टनरशिप करेगा. और रिसेंटली ड्यूरिंग द वर्ल्ड सोलर टेक्नोलॉजी समिट दैट वाज कंडक्टेड बाय इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस एंड फिक्की, इसमें जो हमारे मिनिस्टर ऑफ पेट्रोलियम एंड नेचुरल गैस है डॉक्टर धर्मेंद्र प्रधान, उन्होंने ये अनाउंस किया था दैट 5 PSUs फ्रॉम इंडिया विल पार्टिसिपेट इन दिस कोएलिशन फॉर सस्टेनेबल क्लाइमेट एक्शन. एंड व्हाट आर द नेम ऑफ दीज 5 PSUs? दीज आर ONGC, IOCL, next is HPCL, then we have BPCL, and finally GAIL. Okay, so these are the 5 PSU that have been announced by the Minister of Petroleum and Natural Gas, Dharmendra Pradhan, which will participate in the Coalition for Sustainable Climate Action of International Solar Alliance. Okay, so इसमें जो assembly हुई थी उसमें जो ISA का engagement है with public and private sector for this coalition, this has been institutionalized. All right, and various solar awards were conferred on countries and institutions. So these awards guys are very important. First of all, we have ISA Karnataka Vishveshwarya Award. ISA Karnataka Vishveshwarya Award, which is being given by the Karnataka government, and this award is for those countries which have maximum solar floating capacities in all the four regions. अलग-अलग जितने भी चार regions हैं उन चारों में जो maximum solar floating capacity जिस country के पास है उसको award दिया गया. For Asia Pacific region it was Japan and Netherlands for Europe and other regions. और बाकी जो दो regions बच गए उनके लिए award अभी announce नहीं किया गया है. Okay? And these are other two awards. ISA Kalpana Chawla Haryana Solar Award. Kalpana Chawla was from Haryana, from the city of Karnal. I hope आपको ये सब पता है. And this award is to recognize contribution of scientists and engineers in the field of solar energy sector. And Dr. Bhim Singh from IIT Delhi and Dr. Aisha Al Nuaimi from Dubai Electricity and Water Authority from United Arab Emirates, इन दोनों को ये award दिया गया. Okay. Then we have ISA Diwakar Solar Award. This is to recognize those organizations which are working for the betterment of different differently abled people and have maximized the use of solar energy in the host country. Okay, or do NGO ko ye award diya gaya hai. One is Urban Institute and then we have Arushi Sector. Okay, and these are some more important key points about the assembly. So the assembly was presented the report prepared by the World Resources Institute. World Resource Institute ne ek report banayi thi. That report was presented to the Assembly of International Solar Alliance, and this report identifies the sources of funds, opportunities and constraints in increasing the solar investment. सोलर इन्वेस्टमेंट को बढ़ाने के लिए क्या क्या कॉन्स्टेंट्स है, क्या क्या सोर्सेज है, उसके बारे में इस रिपोर्ट में पूरी बात थी. दिस रिपोर्ट वॉज प्रेजेंटेड टू द असेंबली एंड द असेंबली विल वर्क विद दिस इंस्टीट्यूट वर्ल्ड रिसोर्सेज इंस्टीट्यूट टू डेवलप अ रोड मैप फॉर मोबिलाइजेशन ऑफ $1 ट्रिलियन बाय द ईयर 2030. ओके, एंड इन द वेक ऑफ पैंडेमिक ISA ने ISA केयर्स सेटअप किया था जो कि दैट वॉज ऑन द लाइन्स ऑफ PM केयर्स ऑफ इंडिया to solarize one primary health sector in each district of the target member countries. Okay, this is very important guys, it can be asked in your exam ki in the wake of coronavirus pandemic ISA has set up ISA cares and for what purpose, for setting up one primary health sector with solar power capacity in each district of the target member countries. All right, and these are some more important points. So SARC development fund technical assistance provide karaya jayega of $0.5 million to the member countries of ISA, and in 2020 ISA is focused on operationalizing the ISA Star C network. And what is this Star C network? Solar technology and applications resource center. And under this network, under this project, these type of centers, solar technology and application resource center, will be established in the member countries. These centers will be established in the member countries for attracting investment and generating employment in the solar energy sector. Okay, this is for attracting investment and generating employment, all right, in the solar energy sector. So these centers will be established in the member countries, or 2020 mein ISA ka iske upar pura focus hai. This was also discussed during the assembly, and some various programs जो कि इनिशिएट किए गए हैं बाय इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस सिंस द सेकंड असेंबली. एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड असेंबली, दिस वाज द थर्ड असेंबली, फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड असेंबली बोथ हेल्ड इन इंडिया. सो वेरियस प्रोग्राम्स वर आल्सो हाइलाइटेड बाय द प्रेसिडेंट मिस्टर आरके सिंह. सो डेवलपमेंट ऑफ पाइपलाइन ऑफ मोर देन $5 बिलियन, एंड दिस इज नॉट दैट लिटरल पाइपलाइन. पाइपलाइन का मतलब जो प्रोजेक्ट अंडर कंसिडरेशन है. ओके, so the some projects which are under consideration worth rupees $5 billion, and other than this, aggregate demand of more than 270,000 solar pumps across 22 countries, more than 1 gigawatt of solar rooftop across 11 countries, and more than 10 gigawatt of solar mini grids across 9 countries. Okay, so these are some projects, these are some programs that were highlighted during the assembly. All right, and what is the France role in developing the solar energy sector? So France has committed 1.5 billion euros, okay, 1.5 billion euros for financing solar projects in ISA member countries till the year 2022. Remember the year also, 2022. And also the first project under the solar risk mitigation initiative is being launched in Mozambique. Okay, kahan pe? Mozambique mein launch hua hai under this solar risk mitigation initiative with the support of France and the European Union. Okay, this is European Union. Okay, with the support of France and European Union. So this is, these are some important role of France in developing the solar energy sector across the world. Okay, and now guys, let's come to the question number 2, 3 and 4, which are based on this assembly. And I hope guys ye aapka news pura ka pura clear hai. And if you talk about ISA, so it was established in 2015 and with the efforts of Prime Minister Narendra Modi and French President, और जिसके लिए उन दोनों का अवार्ड भी मिला था, चैंपियंस ऑफ द अर्थ अवार्ड, इफ यू रिमेंबर. इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन गुरुग्राम इन हरियाणा, गुरुग्राम इन हरियाणा. एंड इट हैज अ डुअल ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ बेसिकली यू नो टू डिप्लॉय 1000 गीगावाट ऑफ सोलर एनर्जी बाय द ईयर 2030, एंड ऑल्सो टू मोबिलाइज $1000 बिलियन फॉर टू अट्रैक्ट इन्वेस्टमेंट and generating employment by the 2030 in the solar energy sector. Okay, so this was about ISA, and now let's talk about the question number 2, 3 and 4. So which two countries have been re-elected as the president and co-president respectively of ISA for 2 years in the recently held ISA third assembly? So I hope now you can answer this question. So the president elected is India and co-president is France. So therefore option C, India and France will be the correct answer, because यहाँ पे respectively पूछा है, so France and India cannot be the answer. Okay, France and India गलत मत कर दे रहा, India and France will be the correct answer. And question number 3, during the third assembly of ISA, various solar awards were conferred on countries and institutions. Which of the following statement is correct with respect to the awards presented? So बहुत सारे awards present हुए थे, 3-4 तरीके के, तो आपको वो सारे awards का जो objective है वो याद रखना है कि वो object वो award क्यों दिया जा रहा है and also किसको दिया गया, right? So, Vishweshwarya Award was given to recognize contribution of scientists and engineers working in the field of solar energy. So, kya ye sahi hai? Nahi. It is incorrect. This objective was of the ISA Kalpana Chawla Award. Okay. So, this statement is incorrect. Next is ISA Kalpana Chawla Award was conferred by Haryana government. This is absolutely correct. And iska andaaza isse bhi lagaya ja sakta hai that Kalpana Chawla was from Haryana, from the city of Karnal. And Japan has won the Vishweshwarya Award for Asia Pacific region. This is absolutely correct. So we have two statements correct here, which means option C, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. And question number 4 is also based on this assembly. So with respect to the third assembly of ISA, which was held virtually under the presidency of India, identify the correct statements. So during the assembly, vice presidents were elected for all the 4 regions of ISA. This is absolutely correct. The assembly was presented the report prepared by World Resources Institute. This is also correct, guys. And SAARC Development Fund technical assistance of $0.5 million to the member countries of ISA. This is also correct, which means all are correct, will be the correct answer. Option B. Okay. And now let's talk about the question number 5, which is again a very important question if you talk about the exam. So, which organization has won National Award for Excellence in PSU for Investment in Startups hosted by World HRD Congress? World HRD Congress के द्वारा दिया गया एक award है जिसका नाम है National Award for Excellence in PSU for Investment in Startups. And this guys is very important award because World HRD Congress, I hope आपने कई बहुत कम लोगों ने सुना होगा. So, ये आपसे exam में पूछा जा सकता है. So, now let us discuss about this. So, this award won by TRIFED. किसको मिला है ये अवार्ड? TRIFED को, Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India. If you talk about TRIFED, so it was established in 1987 as a national level cooperative society and it is headquartered in New Delhi. Its MD and CEO is Praveer Shiva. So Mr. Praveer is the first name, so remember the first name only. So 1987 it was established, New Delhi it is headquartered, and it was established with the mandate of development of socio-economic development of the tribal people by providing market to the minor forest produce. Okay, and this TRIFED has won this prize, National Award for Excellence in PSU for Investment in Startup, which was conferred by the World HRD Congress. And what is this World HRD Congress? So it is an annual meet of HR professionals for improving their capabilities. Agla jo event hoga 2021 ka, that will be organized in Mumbai. Okay, and the award recognizes the outstanding initiatives taken by the government department, public sector units and industry people. Okay, and if we talk about the winners, so the team TRIFED usko 3 awards mile hain. First of all, best CEO, or you can say CEO of the year. Then we have visionary leadership award and the full name is Praveer Krishna. Okay, and investment in startup category jo ki pure team ko mila hai. So ye 3 awards hain, CEO of the year, the CEO and MD of TRIFED Praveer Krishna, Visionary Leadership Award Praveer Krishna again, the MD and CEO of TRIFED, and then Investment in Startup category, so the puri team TRIFED ko mila hai. Okay, and these awards were given to the team for transforming the lives of tribal people by generating their livelihood and making them self-reliant. Okay, jo ki TRIFED ka basic objective hai, basic mandate hai. Okay, so this was about this news, guys. Now let's come back to the question. Question is what? Which organization has won this award? So option B, TRIFED, is the correct answer, and don't confuse between TRIFED and NAMFED. Okay, so option B here is the correct answer. And guys, that's it for the session. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.